Good evening and welcome. What I tried to do tonight and again on Monday is collaboration. And so I learned as a very young student in junior high that sometimes our minds get boxed in whatever classroom we think we are in or whatever school we think we're in. So sometimes it's helpful to go outside that box and go, oh, music or art or maybe even science. Science is maybe something bigger than what I'm used to. And maybe this could be something valid. Maybe it's right in that passion. And so with Dr. Trott and wonderful singers of the concert singers at Ole Miss, we decided to give you a concert tonight with collaboration. And so you're going to hear pieces from all over the world. But one thing is that is congruent, that is together, is music. And so we're going to begin with one of our own.
Get it somewhere, way out. is based on Voltaire's satire of the same name that was written in 1759. This musical operetta opened on Broadway on December 1st, 1956. It only ran for 73 shows. Bernstein himself wasn't sure what to even call this musical work. Is it a Broadway musical? Was it an opera? Was it an operetta, a musical operetta? He never really settled on what this name of the piece would really be, the genre. But if you look at the score, it says a musical operetta. And the setting certainly fits that in that it's Voltaire's talk about this really wild story about these two characters, Candide and Cunegonde, and their worldwide travels as they go through finding out about life. So the main character is Candide, a young man who is about to set out on a worldwide travel adventure, going through the towns of Westphalia, Germany, Paris, France, Lisbon, Portugal, Buenos Aires, El Dorado, a mystical village, Constantinople, Cartagena, and eventually Venice. So this is quite a whirlwind tour that we're about to go on. All the while, he's seeking to find the best of all possible worlds and to marry his true love, Cunegonde, who is the daughter of the Baron Thunderton Tromp, who has a castle in Westphalia, Germany, where our story begins in Act One.
This is a story rich and rare.
Teaching Candide the rest about what is the best and the best of all possible worlds.
Possible worlds, what this is the
Baroness Bill, Pandine, and Furuganda are captured and taken away. The next stop is Lisbon. A volcano erupts in Lisbon. Pandine and Pangloss are reunited, although this time Pangloss is a disfigured beggar. He tells Candide of the demise of Westphalia and all at the castle. But Pangloss assures Candide that all is for the best and the best of all possible worlds. The two are overheard by local agents of the Inquisition and arrested as heretics. Pangloss is hung and Candide is flogged. Cunegonde is present for the execution and faints at the sight.
Thank you.
in South America for free passage on the boat to find Cunegonda and the old lady. They soon arrive in Buenos Aires. Candide meets Cacambo, and the two venture into the jungle and find El Dorado, which is a utopian land where there is no war, no hunger, and no greed. But without Cunegonda, Candide is not happy. He wants to take some of the riches that he's found in El Dorado and leave. Candide and Paquette then travel to Cartagena, where they find the old lady on the street. The old lady tells them that Cunegonda has gone to Constantinople. The governor there offers to sail them to Constantinople on the frigate ship Santa Rosalia. Candide sends them with his companion Cacambo on to find Cunegonda, while he secures passage to Venice. A Dutch merchant named Vanderdender offers his ship for passage, but asks for the fare up front. Candide pays with the riches that he has acquired from the utopian city of El Dorado. But the unscrupulous Vanderdender here, noting Candide's fortune, loads his riches, and he sets sail without Candide. Later, Vanderdender's ship is sunk, and Candide sees this as a sign that retributive justice is at work in the world.
Life is life and holy.
decided that it's best to just simply buy a farm near Venice and cast aside wondering about the meaning of a meaningless world, and determines his best of all possible worlds is right here. And Candide asks Cunegonde to marry him. Together, they will live a simple life, and together, build a house, and make the garden grow.
Thank you. kingdom.
Kitso is working for the kingdom. Kitso is working for the kingdom. Make up time to God.
Cause I'm working for the kingdom.
I'm working for the
kingdom.
I'm working for the kingdom.
I'm working for the
kingdom.
just left my brain. Let My Love Be Heard. It's a wonderful piece by a new composer, Jake Lunsad. It's about, it was originally composed for a woman over in California. She was a student of choir. I think it was California State. And as she was singing, unfortunately, she grew up.